Now that you've found UBN Radio and discovered our quality talk shows, it's time to spread the word to friends, family, and the universe. 24 hours of music and talk. Radio without limits. That's why people keep coming back for more. That's UBNRadio.com.
Jump off that exhausting hamster wheel and into balanced living
with Dr. Marissa.
Promise you joy in the mystery.
Dr. Marissa, also known as the Asian Oprah. Her mission, to be a beneficial presence on the planet. Her purpose, to be your personal advocate to live, laugh, love, learn. Her life motto, don't die wondering. Take back your life with Dr. Marissa Payne.
And welcome. You are tuned into my weekly talk radio show called Take My Advice. I'm not using it. Get balanced with Dr. Marissa every Tuesday at Naturally High Noon out of the Universal Broadcasting Network, Sunset Gower Studios, Hollywood, California. And then again on my syndicated CNBC News radio channel, Thursday at 7, Saturday at 1 on KCAA, AM 1050, FM 106.5, 102.3. And now check your listings everywhere for iHeartRadio and Dr. Marissa. And this is a show about hope and happiness. So there's no CNN, no constantly negative news, and good Lord knows if there's a lot of it these days. And also, no gossip, no scandal, and no K-words, no Kardashian talk at all, because I want you to focus in on your own reality show and how you can be happy 88% of the time. So I have topics and guests that highlight that. And before I go on to my guests, I'd like to give a peace shout out to the Long Beach Fire Station, 14 guys who do great work. Thanks for saving the lives that you do. And a shout out to Rena Molina in my spotlight on excellent customer service. It was kind of funny. Usually if I have a good customer service interaction, I tell them to invite them to tune into the show. And it turns out she goes, oh, I listen to you all the time. So peace in and peace out to you, Rena. And I will be giving later on in the show, at the end on my Balance Bar segment, a little reflection piece on the bans on the travel that our 45th president has put on. And we can talk a little bit about that at the end of the show. So I usually don't talk about the CNN, but I've had so many listeners ask what my balance stance is. So we'll be doing that at the end. And without further ado, one more thing. It's official. I have been confirmed as the winner of the Iconic Woman of the Year Award in with the Women's Economic Forum in India. So I get to go and speak there in May. Thank you so much, listeners, everyone who supported me. And I guess I'll get a little bit of that. Very exciting. All right. It keeps getting better. And you know how I am about people who have star power. And it's not the star power that's important. It's what they do with that star power. You know, I had Fran Drescher on talking about reducing risk of cancer. I had Keiko Matsui on to talk about her humanitarian efforts that go along with her music. And today's no different. I am super pleased to have Ryan Long and Jeff Timmons in studio with me to highlight a worthy organization that facilitates Grammy stars and Oscar stars to do just that. Ryan Long is founder and executive producer of the City Summit and Gala, an annual speaker summit and fundraising event held on the weekend of the Grammy Awards. During the summit, influential individuals share their stories on overcoming adversity and inspiration. At the gala, the ceremony honors the most successful people in various industries, including science, entertainment, business, and philanthropy. Last year, the event was held at the Hughes Mansion, a little ironic there, and included a keynote from Sir Richard Branson and honored guests Jane Seymour, Charlize Theron, Haley Berry, and many others. This year, the City Gala is pleased to present its 2017 Lifetime Achievement Award to legendary producer, entertainer, and philanthropist Quincy Jones. And Jeff Timmons, on the other side, is an American pop singer and producer and founding member of the Grammy-nominated pop group 98 Degrees. I can hear the girls screaming in the background right now. Jeff's had phenomenal success both with 98 Degrees and with a Grammy nomination Motown label in movies. My daughters loved the Mulan appearance and he also collaborated with Stevie Wonder and is on his own a multiple TV show star. And mail review. We're going to talk a little bit about that. Touring with Jim Brickman and returns as the MC for this City Gala 2017. Please, without further ado, please welcome to the show Jeff Timmons and Ryan Long.
Thanks for having us. We appreciate it.
Absolutely. So I have a friend who has not a answering machine. She has a questioning machine. And when you call her, it says, who are you and what do you want? So, Ryan Long, who are you and what would you like?
Oh, thank you for that. I am a fundraiser for charitable purposes, and I would like to make an impact doing the type of events that I already do.
So. That's great. And your first event was actually a UN event.
That was not my first event. No,
oh, okay.
That's the very last event that I did.
Okay.
I did it at the United Nations Nova Summit. Yeah.
Yeah. And why, Jeff, is this an important thing for you to do?
Well, I mean, first of all, the City Gala provides services and charitable donations, contributions, influence on a number of different arms. One of them, which is my favorite, any charity that has to do with children, I like to be involved with. And this one's really communities influencing today's youth. And that's sort of the anagram for the charity. And, you know, I've known Ryan for many, many years, been very impressed with him throughout the years, and been fortunate enough to work with him on a number of events. And this is my favorite one, obviously. I got my first taste of it last year. Obviously, it was great to be in the same company as Sir Richard Branson and Jane Seymour. And of course, I've known Puffy Diddy for many, many years. So to reunite with him is fantastic. And it was for a great cause. And it was a well-received event and certainly raised some funds and awareness for the cause. And like I said, anything that has to do with children, especially, I do a number of charity events, but I really love the ones that have to have influence on the kids.
That's great. That's great. And Ryan, I really love the fact that you yourself have gone through what I call alchemy, coming through the fire. And when Cheryl asked if I would have you on, and I read your bio and just the kind of background you came from and that fueling your desire to do what you do, I had to have you on. So take me back there. I'm one of those hosts that likes to get the beginning from the source. So take me back when all this started. What gave you the passion?
I think that if we don't go all the way back to childhood, if we just start with kind of what I would call my rock bottom moment, mm-hmm. which is, you know, in my early 30s, living with grandma, you know, at her house, dead broke, and just, you know, just recently had a breakup with a fiance. We were supposed to be married, and on and on and on. It was bad. Mm. First world problems, right?
Yes.
And so I'm living with grandma, and I turned to personal development and self-help type of books. Mm. So the guys out there that write these things, like Napoleon Hill and
yep.
Tony Robbins and Bob Proctor, you know, I
just
started
had Bob
to,
on the show, you know.
Did you really?
I did. That's so funny.
That
I
must have been a really great show.
Yes.
Because that guy is impeccable.
Yes.
I just love him.
Yes.
And so I started consuming these books, just one right after the other after mm-hmm. the other, and I was immersed in personal development for an entire year. And one of the books, T. Harv Eker is another author, he says, you know, crap moves at the speed of crap. meaning that it takes a while to kind of dust yourself off after having, you know, I was rewiring myself from within.
Mm. No shiitake.
And, right. And so, you know, what actually happened is I started to focus on what is it that I actually want to do.
Mm-hmm.
And I have all these resources. I had been a promoter for a while. I had all these resources and I was broke.
Mm.
And what I actually wanted to do was I wanted to start to do something meaningful with my life. I had embarrassed my family by, you know, several run-ins with the law. I had not been a good testimony for my son.
Mm.
There was just so many things that you know, value-wise, I knew better.
Yeah.
I knew better.
Yeah.
And I was not acting or doing those things.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
So it was a genuine turnaround, and it's still, you know, it's still an everyday thing where I have to continue to live inspired. But I will say this, my intentions are really great. And all that, what I want to do now is this humanitarian type of work. So that's my entire life. That's all I want to do.
That's awesome. That's awesome. You look like you were going to say something there.
Just listening. It's an impressive story. I mean, we've all been through it.
Yes.
I mean, obviously to different degrees, but you know, you hit that rock bottom moment and you have two choices. You can quit or you can move forward.
Yeah.
And it's impressive to see where Ryan's come. I mean, I've known him for a long time.
Yeah, I can tell you guys sort of like each other. I couldn't break
absolutely.
Them away from hugging to get him over here for a picture. I was going to take a crowbar. But that's
but
beautiful
just,
to see that.
I want to tell you, you know, last year, you know, Jeff really saved the entire show, the City Gala, with his experience and what was going on, from, you know, announcing Sir Richard Branson to Diddy doing a Kanye on stage, you know, breaking into to Branson's performance.
Let's just put it this way. I've been in worse situations right. where I've had plenty of experience having to improv in worse situations than being at the Playboy Mansion with Richard Branson and a bunch of celebrities for yeah. a good cause. So it was easy for me. And again, you know,
he's a great MC.
Yes.
I
mean,
and it's one of those things where I just naturally, because he's world-class entertainer,
yeah.
For him to be the MC of the event and host and use his faculties in sort of a different way than he's used to some a performance type of thing.
Right.
But the way that he came in and is on board, there was no way that I wasn't going to have him back him to come back
right.
for this year. He's so charitable. He gets involved. He gets involved with the promotion. He's tweeting. He's texting. He's sharing. He's that kind of guy that
that's
you want
amazing.
Involved. So.
That's amazing. And it's going to be a great night. And you were generous enough to donate to my show. And so for all of those of you, because I was given the honorable moniker, the Asian Oprah, actually several years back when I won the 2014 Asian Entrepreneur of the Year. And they brought me on stage and they went, oh, and here's the Asian Oprah. And I went, like that, I'm like, really? And so immediately some of the people, well, are you going to give a car away on the air? And I'd say, someday, you know, night. And today, because of your generous donation of two VIP $10,000 a piece tickets, I am actually giving away what equates to a small car. So I'm grateful for that. And if you're just tuning in and wondering if I'm really giving away cars on the air, you are tuned in to take my advice. I'm not using it. Get balanced with Dr. Marissa. And today's wonderful guests, we have two fine-looking gentlemen, by the way, Ryan Long and Jeff Timmons from 98 Degrees, for those of you who recognize him. And they're here talking about a very worthy event that's coming up, Grammy weekend. And I was asked to cover it, Peace In and Peace Out to Cheryl Connor, who actually orchestrated me in the midst of this. And it is an event that is going to not only provide wonderful entertainment for anyone that goes, it is also raising funds. And this year, your target is
We spread the event into 2 days now. So what actually happened is I did a summit at the UN, and it really inspired me. The summit, you can't raise money, you know, at the United Nations. In essence, it's not a venue where you can sell tickets to.
No,
you know?
No.
And
although lately.
but it really inspired me to take a look at last year's gala. I felt like, you know, it was real glitzy and glamorous, and that was cool and everything, and it's on the night of the Grammys. And the intention is good, meaning we wanted to make an impact.
Mm-hmm.
But what did people walk away saying? They walked away saying, hey, that was a great party.
Right.
So this year I wanted to stay on message. And so that the listeners and so that you guys know, the service that I actually provide is that we launch new charitable startup foundations through our event. So it's a new charity each year. And what Jeff was talking about earlier is International Arts and Philanthropy Foundation is mm-hmm. One of the organizations that we're launching this year. And they do have a youth mentorship program and an early childhood okay. development program. And I just love being involved with these mm-hmm. kind of things, helping mm-hmm. new startup non-for-profits get their seed funding through our events.
Perfect.
So now we have a 2-day program.
Mm-hmm.
The City Summit is more like a business conference, if I could say it mm-hmm. that way. And we're going to announce a keynote, and it's going to be very big. I apologize. I don't have an exclusive for you right now. But I can say that representatives from Virgin Galactic and Google and NASA and on will be there to speak. Rags to riches, billionaires, people of influence are going to speak, share, and contribute. Mm-hmm. Jeff will also be talking about his, you know, personal biography in a moderated discussion, and some of the, you know, the overcoming of adversity that
I love that theme. Yeah. I love that thing. And everybody is in that class. I don't know anyone who has not had some kind of life opportunity. I don't call them challenges. Opportunity for improvement. And you always have a choice whether to grab onto it, as you did, or just lay in bed and eat bonbons for another 10 years and wonder where your life went. And I also love, you know, people ask me all the time, I don't have self-esteem. You know, I don't feel good about myself. I don't like who I am. And so then the next question is, well, what are you doing about that? Esteem comes from esteemable acts. The fact that you admit where you were and now are making concerted efforts every single day to do the best that you can, that's how you get to the place where you start feeling good about yourself. It's an inside job, right? Sorry, I'm starting to sound like Bob.
Hey, we love it. We like to hear that. Those are the words we like to hear.
Yeah, yeah. And then I was going to wait till the end of the show to talk about this, but I think I have to talk about, you know, what's going on, right? So we now have a ban on 7 different countries. Some people feel like they're in the dark ages again, or, you know, we're being launched back into that. And they're feeling very mad and angry and hating. And I've been very straight about, you know, we can't hate because then we're putting ourselves into the same feeling frame or vibratory frame as those people who are that we're angry with. So your organization is a great example of, we can't control some things, but we can control others. So at an individual level, we do the best that we can with what we have and the resources we have and the time we have. That's at an individual basis. At a group basis, we continue to get involved with organizations that are standing for development in community, standing for human rights, standing for what is right and good and whole and non-discriminatory and non-misogynistic. So that's why this is so important. So if you're complaining and you're marinating in the hate, or you're so sad that you can't get out of bed, here's a program, a 2-day, that you can go and learn something on how you can help your community. How's that for an ad?
Absolutely, yes.
You're hired.
Thank you. Are you available?
I'm available. Why do I do this show? Yeah. I'm not here really to entertain. I really want people to know that they have choices,
right,
and they can do something with their money.
You know, one of the comments that I'd like to throw in is I was talking to the vice president of Virgin Galactic, and so that everybody knows, Virgin Galactic is taking people to outer space. It's an outer space ride. Wow. It's Sir Richard Branson's company, where you get to basically, you know, shuttle to outer space and back. And I was talking to Will about this, and Will Pomerantz is the vice president of Virgin Galactic. And, you know, these guys are really, you know, they have a lot more information than, you know, the average citizen in the United States. And I was asking him, I said, look, in the political climate, and he said, we're not even concerned about that. He says, listen, when you go to space, the very, very first thing that you see is that there are no lines on that map, that there's a thin layer of the ozone, you know, there's a very thin layer of our atmosphere, and that is just a world, and there are people in it. And
so much bigger than this.
Yeah, and he just the way that he described it, and this guy's, you know, kind of, I mean, he's a Harvard grad, you know, he's much smarter than I am, but for the way that he described the necessity of humankind to treat each other, you know, with equality,
kindness, humankind,
and that these borders that we are fighting over don't actually really exist.
Right. Right.
Was a very interesting take, and he's going to speak on one of the panels at the summit.
Fabulous.
And so you get that knowledge is, like that, you know.
Yeah, yeah, that's great. I'm thinking I'm gonna throw my pad in there if it's not too late. I would love to. It's so important that we not get to that point of, you know, let's assassinate. I mean, come on, that's not where we want to go. But there are solutions, and I'm kind of excited. It's really unfolding, and the best thing that I've heard lately is because he's ripped off that scab of infection on our country with one foul swoop, at least now the infection can heal. So I had a guy that runs the Veterans for Peace organization. I would love to introduce you to. I think you'd be best friends. And he said, we've never really healed from the Civil War. If you think about it, that all went underground. And so now we get a chance to heal it. And never in our history of Americans have we been so cognizant of what our constitutional right to freedom is. Never. So isn't that great? I know I'm a silver lining girl. I put on my life jacket with a silver lining. Pollyanna is my little name, middle name. But isn't it great that we all are, you know, globalized in this understanding, and we're coming together on it. Ryan, I know that you were going to say something. Jeff.
Ryan. No, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, what seems to be a developing more publicly and virally now has been in existence forever. And so, despite the negative spin that the media has been, you know, sort of portraying this situation, and some see it as bleak, but there is, I feel the same way as you do. I look at everything in a positive light. I mean, I think that's part of the inspiration you get from studying self-help. Like I have that in common with Ryan. I share some of the same favorite books and authors and motivational speakers and whatnot. But yeah, I mean, I think it definitely, it makes you have to deal with the problem.
Yes.
One way or another. And
yes.
So, you know, by drawing attention to the problem, you have to remedy it. And I think it's a positive thing.
Yes. For individuals, stay in the solution. Don't keep complaining about the problem. Look for the solution and play in the solution. I think that's it can be a creative exercise. So how do we find, how do we get tickets? City.org?
Citygala.org.
Citygala.org.
Yep.
Okay.
And click on admission and you'll be prompted for an application.
And all of this is tax deductible.
It's a tax deductible donation to charity.
And it's great. And then we're going to have speakers. And that first day is at USC, correct?
That's at the USC Tower, okay. Downtown Los Angeles.
I'm yeah. Not going to say anything.
February 11th.
I taught at UCLA in the MBA school, but I won't say anything about USC. It's okay. It's a good cause. We'll go to USC for the day. And then
I want to describe it.
Okay.
The USC Tower is the former AT&T building. This is not on USC campus.
Oh, then yeah. I can go.
There you go.
There you go. You're not in enemy territory.
Yes.
There.
Now you can hang out. And then the second day, February 12th, the night of the Grammys, is at the Walt Disney Concert Hall.
Great. And the red carpet on Saturday starts at
8 a.m.
8 a.m. Mm-hmm. Early red carpet.
Yeah.
And I'll be covering that. So I'll be there. If you're there, I will see you and you get a picture with all of us. And then at 9 is when the panels start.
Yes, 9 is when the discussions
and
start.
And then we have a keynote, there's a big keynote
networking,
coming up.
Yeah, there's networking mixed in between. We have an itinerary that's listed, citygala.org/summit.
Perfect. And then the following day after the Grammys, are you going to go?
Am I going to go to the Grammys?
Yes.
No, I'm not. Are you going, Jeff?
No, I'm actually not going this year. Yeah.
Okay, then I don't feel so bad. I'm not going either. But we are going to be
as a matter of fact,
after
a lot of the artists are boycotting the Grammys this year. It's not in a negative spin, but it's a lot of artists don't feel the Grammys is relevant anymore. Justin Bieber's not coming. He's nominated for 4. Kanye West isn't coming.
Oh, wow.
You know, Frank Ocean
That's
started
another
it
K
off.
Word.
He's
wow.
not coming. Kanye. Yeah. I'm a
another
big fan
K
of Kanye.
Oh, okay.
Never
mind.
But you know, look, a lot of folks don't feel like it caters towards young black artists. And so there are people that are boycotting for that reason. It's a completely peaceful boycott, yet they feel that, you know, the Grammys is, to quote Frank Ocean, is a dinosaur. I can't say that I agree with that. I think it's still an honorable organization, but I certainly see their point of view for sure. I mean, mm-hmm. I definitely think there needs to be, as the Oscars has now transitioned into being more diverse this year, maybe the Grammys will consider that as well.
Mm, interesting. Yeah, and you're connected to that whole, how that whole thing that happened with the inauguration and people pulling out of performing, what was your take on that?
Well, look, I one of the things I don't do as a recording artist is talk politics, because there's no winning. Mm-hmm. I mean, I have my certain beliefs about religion, spirituality, politics. If someone asks me about it, I'll be more than happy to share my beliefs, but I don't push my beliefs or philosophies on anybody.
Right.
I think your journey, your spiritual journey, your journey through this life is just completely personal, mm-hmm. and completely your own personal history and sort of something that you have to go through and learn and grow from on your own, and take what you can from different people and learn from those situations and be influenced by people. But I think it's all complete. All of those things are all completely up to you.
Yes.
But as far as the inauguration and artists not performing, if they don't believe in the cause or they don't believe in some of the platforms and philosophies that our now president has, then I can understand why they wouldn't want to perform, because it then shows that they're supporting a cause that they may not believe in.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a... Did you want to chime in on that?
Yeah, I mean, I think that first of all, Jeff is right on point. You know, I subscribe to that. Look, it's peaceful. Don't show up. You mm-hmm. know, you don't believe the same thing. Mm-hmm. You don't subscribe to someone's standards or ethics, or just you're fine. Don't show up.
Yeah,
and I think that that's okay.
I had
and what's going on across the United States, the marches, the walks, the activities, it's just brilliant.
Mm-hmm.
It's wonderful to see that people are willing to stand up for something that they believe in, and they believe is justice.
Yeah.
And that's what they believe. And so, I mean, I think it's unheard of, unprecedented. I've never seen anything like it in my life.
Yeah,
it's kind of nice to see. I mean, it's very nice to see, because I mean, I think as of late, people have become so complacent with, look, these things we hold in our hands. You have your own personal entertainment device in your hand at all times. And so it becomes easy to become a pacifist and sit back and watch everything unfold.
Yeah.
So again, like you said, pulling the scab off and making people aware of what's really been going on all this time and what's sort of festering under the surface has inspired people and gotten people out of their seats to literally get up and walk and stand up for what they believe in. It's very impressive and it's exciting.
Yes, it is. I actually woke up with this thought. I'm going to put a wanted poster up, and I want a savvy businessman or woman with a conscience, well-versed in constitutional law and an understanding of any loopholes on government leadership, who values diversity and thinks twice about unintended consequences before making a decision, who doesn't degrade women in and out of locker rooms, who hates terrorism but knows that there are other ways besides walls and bans to rid the world of them. That's what I want, because I think
that person just left office.
yes. So we have to figure. Well, and I was thinking Bernie Sanders, Hillary Clinton, Dalai Lama, but Dalai Lama is not American, so we can't go there. But Warren Buffett. So, here's a time where we've got a lot of people marching and we've got a lot of people standing up for their own thing, right? Who can galvanize all of that energy into one place so that we can really do something different?
It has to inspire people enough to get up and move. And now we're talking about after the fact, people are getting up and moving. And you alluded to Bernie Sanders, the wonderful Hall of Fame football player. To Bernie Sanders, and he was appealing to the youth. And some of the demographics that don't necessarily get up and aren't actively voting like they should.
Yeah.
And so I think it's somebody that appeals, that adopts sort of those principles that you described, along with some of the platforms that Bernie was bringing to the table, and appeals to the youth. And I think it might take a younger person to do that, not to discriminate against older folks.
Yeah.
But, look, if somebody can relate to somebody that's more along their peer group, mm-hmm. it might inspire them and get them out of their seats and moving and getting out there to the polls and voting
right. Yeah, I just had a thought of a consortium. We have someone that appeals to the young. We have someone that appeals to the veterans. We have someone appeal to diversity and have a leadership by consortium.
That's what's supposed to be our government. it's supposed to be Congress.
Good point.
It's not always represented that way. Yeah. Unfortunately, things have tipped and become more corporate
You have to get money out of politics. Yeah. You know, that's one of the things. And and you know, the other thing that I'd love to comment on is that the world is getting smaller and more transparent. Mm-hmm. And so if you make a mistake, it's at this day and age, it's better to own it and say it and apologize for it than to try to hide it, pretend it, or spin it, because that's what is getting people in the most trouble these days.
Yeah.
And
owning your side of the street.
You do. I mean, Donald Trump went around the world or around the country owning it, you know, just being like, yeah, that's me. And it resonated with some people.
Yeah.
And and his opponent didn't.
Yeah.
And or did sometimes and didn't at other times. And I think that you know, so that's the United States, but there's an entire world to think about. And if we're bringing people together to unite people together, we need leaders that are willing to get vulnerable, you know, understand that they make mistakes as well. Mm-hmm. Yes. I did that. Yes. I made a mistake, you know, and I own that. Yeah. And then you can, I watched a TED talk recently that said all of your strength lies in owning your vulnerability. Mm-hmm. And I really subscribe to that.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And it also encouraging. I got an email. My daughter goes to Cornell, and the president of Cornell wrote this letter, and a bunch of the Ivy League schools are banding together and saying, we don't support the ban. We don't support what's going on. Alliance International University, where I was on the board, also came out that so things are, you know, it is causing us to stand up and say something different, which is what we have to do, right?
Completely. I mean, you can't sit back and just watch everything unfold and then complain about it. I mean, you have to be active. Yeah, the first step is action.
Yeah,
I mean, if you want change, so
that's right.
You know, thought then action. But you know,
perfect segue to the sponsor of the show today. Me with my 21-day fast from complaining with Dr. Marissa. We'll be back in 2 and 2. Peace in and peace out.
No way! I'm so cold. I'm so hot. I'm so hungry. I'm so full.
Did that complaining sound familiar to you? Hi, I'm Dr. Marissa, your cheerleader for hope and happiness 88% of the time, and they also call me the Asian Oprah. Well, I have a perfect app for you if you want to lose negative weight and stop complaining. Yes, the 21-day Fast from Complaining with Dr. Marissa app is now available. Every day you'll get a balanced tip that keeps you from complaining, as well as some sound effects. If you do complain and you press a button, it will give you a sound to keep you from complaining. And if you make it the entire day without complaining, you'll get a nice warm And there's a YouTube link also to help you not complain. And then at the end of the 21 days, because it takes 21 days to create a good habit, you'll get an overall score as well as a way to post your triumph with your friends and family on Facebook. So don't complain, have fun, and remember it's all about balance. Peace in and peace out.
Peace in, peace out.
And we are back. You are tuned into my weekly talk radio show called Take My Advice. I'm not using it. Get balanced with Dr. Marissa every Tuesday at Naturally High Noon out of the Sunset Gower Studios in Hollywood, California with Universal Broadcasting Network. And then syndicated every Thursday at 7, Saturday at 1 at my CNBC News radio channel, KCAA AM 1050, FM 102.3, FM 106.5, and now everywhere on iHeartRadio. And today, I am so blessed to have two really like-minded, love-hearted gentlemen, good-looking too, in the studio with me, Ryan Long and Jeff Timmons, who are here offering and talking and promoting peace through an organization called City Gala. And at the end of our show, I will be giving away 2 VIP tickets to this fabulous event that happens the day before and then the evening after the Grammy Awards, valued at $20,000. So stay tuned and I will tell you how to get a chance to win those tickets. And we're going to come back and find out why you chose Quincy Jones as your 2017 achievement winner for the City Gala.
Well, first, I want to say that Jeff had some comments on Quincy, and I wanted to get Jeff's comments first because I know all about the how we organize the whole thing. But Jeff is a musician, and to be in the industry and know, you know, who Quincy Jones is and what he's done, you know. I
never expected to be a singer growing up. I kind of fell into it in college, but you know, one artist I followed that everybody followed was Michael Jackson, and Quincy Jones was the man. You don't want to say behind Michael Jackson because Michael Jackson would probably take exception that somebody was behind his talent, but Quincy Jones was behind Michael Jackson's talent in the studio.
Okay.
And so, you know, when I got into the business and really was fascinated, I like being behind the scenes. Unfortunately, it keeps pulling me back in front of the scenes, but I love being behind the scenes in the studio. There's nobody better or more legendary or more esteemed or more revered or more accomplished mm-hmm. than Quincy Jones. And speaking mm-hmm. of the Grammys, I think he has like 80 Grammys or something crazy like that. And I've always wanted the opportunity to speak with him, be in the same room with him. Mm-hmm. I went and saw him speak once, but to share the stage and honor him yes. at an event that I'm blessed enough to host that is a giving back spiritual, you know, charitable organization. It's like a dream come true. When Ryan told me that he was the honoree this year, I lost it on the phone. I mean, Halle Berry's great and everything, yeah. but, you know, Quincy yes. Jones is my guy.
Yeah. Yeah, that's great. That's great.
And so if you want to ask, all you have to do is look. You know, you asked me why are we honoring him with a Lifetime Achievement Award? Take a look. Yeah. I mean, all he's done, what he represents is bringing people together. He's the producer of We Are the World. I think it's the most listened to ever song.
Beautiful.
Of all time. And mm-hmm. We Are the World is of course Michael Jackson is famously, you know, out in front of that, but it was a collaboration of many artists. Mm-hmm. Quincy Jones was of course the producer of it, but his career spans even back before that to mm-hmm. producing Frank Sinatra, and you know, I mean,
I didn't know that
he's just legendary.
Yes.
He is iconic.
That I knew.
he represent. If you're talking about a lifetime achievement. And to commit to mastery and then also be a kind-hearted, giving soul that you know whose only desire is to just do his best, be his best, and then be a great testimony for everybody else around him.
Yeah,
that is Quincy Jones.
Yeah,
and so I'm honored to honor him. I'm like, you know, I'm excited and broken to bits. Like, I can't wait for February 12th. I will say this kind of behind the scenes. His people said to me, you want to have an award show after the award show? And I said, well, yes it's just, I mean, it's, you know, the Walt Disney Concert Hall is about a mile away from the actual Grammys where the Staples Center is.
Right.
And that's going away, by the way. Next year, the Grammys are returning to New York. I'm not sure.
Interesting to know. Yeah, I didn't know that.
And so it's just, he's gonna attend the Grammys, and then he'll show up at the Walt Disney Concert Hall to be honored.
Yeah.
But I think, you know, lifetime achievement. If there were a bigger or better award that I can give, I'd give him that one. But
yeah.
Lifetime achievement is I mean,
it's
his life is a great testimony.
Yeah.
To everybody, to be and stay committed to your craft and philanthropic work, you know, advancing community and humanitarian activity.
I think he's one of the only people I know that has not had any bad press.
It's, yeah.
Right?
I agree.
I mean,
not one. Like, I don't know anybody that has not had, well, Stevie Wonder's not had bad press.
No.
Right?
Oh, right.
So,
right, yeah.
So. But I actually met Quincy Jones at the Playboy Jazz Festival a couple years back.
Very cool.
And got a sort of half picture with it.
Hey, at least you got one.
At least I have one. I know, and
I'm
just realized
that, and I'm
going to
crop you out and put my photo next to it.
You will not. I'm could kick myself because I didn't bring it to flash up there, but I'll put it on my Facebook. But I am just really, really glad and happy and honored that you guys came on here to share this very, very worthy cause. And I'm hoping that all my listeners will come and join me. I think there still are tickets left. I think the regular tickets are 1,000. And again, is it 1,000 or 1,500?
It's 1,500 general and 10,000 VIP.
Right. Mm-hmm. And the VIP, the difference is?
The difference is a backstage pass and photo opportunity with the hosts and honorees and keynote speakers.
Awesome. And is there a poker game again?
There is a celebrity poker
game. Celebrity poker game, yeah. At the night of,
the
right?
night of. That's
and
on,
then
at the
you
Walt
have
Disney
some
concert
Entrepreneur Magazine is
the presenting
sponsor. Mm-hmm. And there's other sponsors too. I think Patron is going to again.
Yeah, Patron is sponsoring the VIP room. So the VIP room is going to be very active, and there's going to be a lot of passion and fun involved in that.
And I get lighthearted,
yes.
Loose backstage.
don't go there.
Oh, yeah. Relax.
I still want to know about your. Was it Chippendales you were on?
I hosted.
Hosted.
I was not on or a member of the cast of the Chippendales. I hosted the Chippendales.
You hosted.
And it ended up, you know, I was really reluctant to do it. My wife said, "Look, it's a Vegas show. Go check it out." I said, "Everybody's going to think I'm a stripper." I went and hosted it. Everybody thought I was
a stripper.
It was all over the press everywhere. The show ended up being sold out. And then, you know, look, I think it might have been a catalyst to get my group back together. You know, we started getting a lot of attention, not that the group needed it. And Nick obviously has been doing his thing for a long time. But I think that, you know, everybody was me getting up and singing the 98 Degrees songs and realizing that we are selling out these shows. We recognize that our fans never go away. And
yes.
So we
he
got
just
back
sold
together.
Out two United States. Was it two tours in a row, two yeah. summers in a row? The group got back together, and the last one was My 2K, right?
That's right. Thanks, man. Yeah, My 2K. We're fortunate.
I only remember it because you were on tour when I was at the UN, and I wanted.
Oh, that's
to go
right.
So bad.
And I really wanted to go to that. That's the only thing that would have stopped me from something like that.
Yeah.
What's the number one song that people just absolutely have to have you sing?
You know what?
You're out of my
life. We're fortunate that we've had quite a few.
Yes.
But you know, I think the hardest thing, or I do, is a universal wedding song. I can go anywhere in the world, no matter what they language the folks speak, and whatever country I'm in, they know that song.
Okay.
And that one's pretty much been perpetually out there throughout the years.
Okay.
But we were fortunate to have five or six top ten songs.
So. I went in my research. I did the playlist of somebody put a playlist of all your best songs. So that was kind of nostalgic for me and remembering.
Right.
Even
it's
though I'm
so
ageless.
Far back, you know, that's of
I'm
course
ageless,
that's when they
even myself there.
Yeah,
whoops!
So
what did I just say? Dang it!
That's right. Someone told you about our songs.
Yes, exactly, So when are you going? Like, how do we find you?
You know, look. My website's jefftimmons.com, and all the social medias stuff, I'm on there. It's just at Jeff Timmons everywhere, and Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and all the other ones, Snapchat. You know, we're very hands-on, and I'm still doing a lot of stuff. I'm producing a couple TV shows and producing a couple more and going to go overseas on my own. Well, I did a movie with the boy band guys, a very, very Oscar-worthy performance, a show called Dead 7 for the Sci-Fi Channel, you know, in the tradition of Sharknado. But it was a blast. And we're talking about doing another one in a bigger scale and releasing it into the movie theaters this time around. So there was a surprise cult following to that. And, you know, not really because all the boy band guys have their you know, dedicated fan bases. And they've stayed with us throughout the years and grown with us. And they've been very loyal and helped us, you know, live the dream for over 20 years now. So
how long was 98 Degrees together the first time?
Well, I think, you know, we were out for about 5-6 years straight.
5-6 years.
And that was, you know, sort of like being shot out of a cannon.
Yes, Motown.
We went from leaving Ohio and dropping the hat here at Santa Monica Pier for money in Fisherman's Wharf to playing stadiums everywhere. So it was like a whirlwind, really.
What happened?
We wanted a break. I mean, you know, 6 consistent years of being on the road away from your families, you know, kind of took a toll. Not that we, you know, sort of had a negative idea about what was going on or any feelings about it. It just was a grind. And, you know, we all wanted to have families. We started a little later in the game, so we weren't boys in our, quote, boy band. We were men.
Right.
And we wanted to have kids. And so we you know, a couple of us started having kids, and we got married, and, you know, wanted to transition behind the scenes, producing things, doing radio, TV, you know, producing music for other folks. And that's what we did. And then we were like, wow, you know, let's get back together and see what it's like. And it turned out to be great.
So. Is it weird?
No, it's awesome. We're having a blast. We got nothing to worry about. We all have different things we're doing. We all have steady careers, family, you know, solid foundations. And now it's just like, let's go have fun. Let's go perform for the fans. We don't have to worry about a record company or selling albums or selling tickets. Right. They're there. People will buy whatever and support us. And we're just having a blast. So now we're like, wow, why couldn't we have had this much fun 20 years ago? So, we want to continue the tradition. I think we're going to put something together for Christmas this year. So.
Oh, that's great.
His fans are avid.
Yeah, that's an understatement. They're great.
I bet. Good that's fans. Great. Well, I do want to give both of you the Dr. Marissa Beneficial Presence on the Planet Award.
All right.
For the work that you do. Here's an award for before the award.
Thank you. Well, thank you.
Thank you very much.
And I don't give that to everyone, so please do be honored by that.
Thank you.
I love when people do more than complain.
I was going to say, I think I can speak for both of us. In fact, I know. I mean, we're honored to be on this show, too, and the support that you're showing us for the event and City Gala. So thank you
for having us.
Yes, yeah. That's Mandarin for thank you, by the way, in case you thought I was Swedish. But the last thing I usually like to do with guests is, who would you like to thank in the realm of gratitude that helped you be who you are now?
My mom. Mm. I'd like to thank my mother.
What's her name?
Her name is Donna.
Hi, Donna.
Yeah. My grandparents, my grandma and my grandfather.
Beautiful.
For sure. And then everybody that's helped me professionally, I can go on and on and on. But that's where it starts for me. And shout out to my son, Aaron.
Oh, beautiful. And?
I'd like to thank you again for having us.
Absolutely.
Really appreciate it. My friend Tony for bringing us in.
Tony Sweet.
He's awesome. Tony Sweet.
Yep.
But, you know, look, Ryan, for having me be a part of this event now 2 years in a row, it is a big honor for me.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, look, I come from a great family as well. Great parents, great grandparents. Of course, I want to express my gratitude for them. But my wife's amazing. She, I was not too long ago was in a bad spot like Ryan was talking about. She kind of brought me out of it in sort of that rising phoenix kind of way. And my kids are amazing also. So, but I have great fans out there. So they support everything I do. They're going to support this event and now hopefully transition. And I know they're going to be avid listeners of your show as well. So
fabulous. Thank you so much. Thanks. And that is it for the official portion, the Asian Oprah giveaway of the two VIP tickets. Drum roll, please. I don't think we have a drum roll. We're going to have to get one because this is a momentous $20,000 giveaway. The first person to go to my website, the number 4balance.org, and put in the contact form, let's put in City Gala. And that way, I'll give you the two VIP tickets and we'll see you there. All right? How's that?
Excellent.
All right. And thank you again for coming on.
Thanks so much. Congratulations.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you. All righty. Another fabulous show. And this is time for Balance Bar. When I ask you to come and balance with me, and I think we talked pretty much about everything that I wanted to give about the seven country ban, and again, focusing on what you can do and staying in the solution and being positive. As well, I would like to invite you to join the upcoming round 67 of the 21-day Fast from Complaining with Dr. Marissa. Starts February the 1st. All you need to do is buy a 99-cent app made by teenagers. You heard the ad in the middle of the show. Google Play, Apple Store. And this round, I have challenged Ryan, and he has accepted. So we're going to do it together to see how many days in a row. Jeff has bowed out because he does not think he can do 21 minutes because he just was complaining on social media about his Twitter not working well. So we're going to leave him out of that competition. But if you'd like to join myself and Ryan in this round, the winner gets a pack of my motivational cards called 52 Card Pick-Me-Ups, Stacking the Deck for Life Balance with Dr. Marissa, valued at $10. So please do sign up and join. As well, please come to my Sedona retreat for another Balance in the Vortexes. That will be May 20 and 21st in the beautiful Red Rocks of Sedona, if you haven't gone there. And it's only $800, including two nights at either the Sedona Summit, the Los Abrigados Resort and Spa, or the Bell Rock Inn. And if you sign up by Valentine's Day, perfect gift, you save $200. So there's no excuses for not joining me. And an important change because of the building issues at Agape, my Balanced Tai Chi Gong class has been moved and postponed. But because so many people wanted the retreat, I'll still be having a Balance on the Beach workshop on March 4th, the same day. So get on my Facebook group or email list, again, at drmarissa.tv, if you'd like to balance with me, your personal advocate for happiness 88% of the time. Finally, next week, we are going to weigh in, literally and figuratively, with my guest, Dr. Lionel King, who's been coaching me. He's the No Diet No More coach. And thanks to him, in 30 days of my new Facebook free group called Feel Good and Look Good Naked on Facebook, I have been now I've released 6 pounds and 9 inches, so I'm getting back to dating weight, so I can look good naked, so that clothes are not a false advertising anymore. Anyways, please do tune in next week for that really important show on not dieting and eating healthy. As well, the following week we're having my annual very funny 4-time Oprah, 5-time Asian Oprah guest, Dr. Pat Allen, who Oprah calls the comic, Mother Supreme comic. And she will be on again to grace us with her humor and also to rake me over the romance coals again. So that is February 14th, the actual day of Valentine's, otherwise known as Single Awareness Day. So don't forget next week, next month, because we didn't have sexual healing with Dr. Marissa today, because I wanted to get Ryan on before his event. We will have 2 sexual healings next month with Dr. Pat Allen. And then I also have Todd Krieger coming on with increasing your potential for a better orgasm. So that will be the last week of the month. So keep it tuned to Take My Advice, I'm Not Using It, Get Balanced with Dr. Marissa Pay. That's P for positive, EI. And remember, it's all about balance. Peace in and peace out.
Part of me that wants to stay. It's all I want to hear my life and sing along. For without it, there's no laughter, no tears, lonely days after, no memories for the way things used to be. Many a friend has stopped.